All right, in this video, we're going to go over the Premier and Enterprise Manufacturing and Wholesale, kind of some things that set it apart, the industry edition that is Manufacturing and Wholesale. So when you first install your QuickBooks, you're going to see something that looks similar to this, where you choose which edition, contractor, manufacturing, nonprofit, professional, retail, which edition you want to install on your computer, okay? Basically what it is it just kind of makes, there's a couple changes that it makes that are more geared towards that particular industry and some different reporting and things like that. Okay, so first thing that I always notice is the estimates area over here. It says quotes. In the contractor edition, it says estimates and change orders. In this one, it says quotes and estimates. And just regular old QuickBooks, it just says estimates. So because usually, in the manufacturing, we're giving out quotes, that's more of a standard terminology that is used, then they change that there. Okay. They also have here under manufacturing and wholesale, you have your own manufacturing and wholesale dropdown where you can create quotes, sales orders, the sales order fulfillment worksheet here. So you see all your open sales orders, all the details. You can mass print your pick lists and packing slips, okay? And you can sort it by the date entered, by customer job, by order number. And then you can also come down here and say, I want to choose all orders with the earliest ship date, with the earliest order date, largest potential revenue. So this is your sales order fulfillment area. Okay. You also have, create invoices, receive deposits, receive payments, make deposits, create purchase orders, receive items, all that fun stuff having to do with inventory. You can get your items list here also. Then you have your inventory activities. Make a new item. This is something that's neat. You can change your item prices. So you can do a mass change on your items here. So if you want to choose all your inventory parts, looks like a lot of them don't have prices in there. So we're going to go ahead and add some new prices. Okay. And you can adjust it so that it mass changes the prices. 500, 200, 100. And say okay. All right. And then you also have here your price level list. So you can have different price levels for your customers. If they're a wholesale customer versus a retail customer, the wholesale customer might get 10% off across the board. Or you can even come up with an individual price list. Of course, adjusting the quantity on hand, the physical inventory worksheet, build assemblies, all those are standard. Then it comes with a couple of different logs that are pretty normal in the manufacturing industry too. The RMA authorization form. All right. So they have a form. It opens up in Word so you can print it out. They also have here the non-conforming materials report, which is something similar in the damaged goods log, something similar here. Okay. So that you can print this out and keep a copy of it in your damaged goods folder. All right, and then here we also have manufacturing wholesale reports, some reports that are specific to the industry. Again, sales by class and by item type, sales by rep, by product, inventory reorder report by vendor. So some good reports, profitability by product here. All right. And this gives profitability on service too, which is a report that a lot of people ask me about. All right, so again, those can also be found here under manufacturing and wholesale reports as well. So that is a quick peek at the manufacturing and wholesale edition.